Hello friends, welcome to MathAlcoholic once again. In this video, I'll be starting with exercise 1.4 of Relations and Functions Class XII NCERT Mathematics. So, to gist out, this exercise is primarily focused on binary operations. Now, before we leap onto the problems, we will have a basic start of what is binary operations. Any operation, you know, there are arithmetic operations like plus, minus, multiply, divide, divisions. These are arithmetic operators. You have used it in primary mathematics as well as in programming languages. Now, likewise, binary operation is an operation that is defined between two elements. There are two elements that belongs to any domain or range, and within these two elements we have some relation that is given by this operation. Now, in an arithmetic operation, this binary operation, this is the symbol of a binary operator. Now, this operator can be anything that can operate between A and B. See, this can be plus, minus, multiply, divide, because plus, minus, multiply, divide are operations that include both these elements. Okay, so here we are to find that which operations are binary operations. Now, a binary operation should not be obsolete. It must have to hold for AB and BA equally on the given domain and range. It should not exceed its corresponding limit. So with this understanding, first, the question number one, we are said to find out those which are binary operations and which are not. So starting with question number one, so it's pretty simple. On Z plus, we define star by A star B is equal to A minus B. So we are writing it on Z plus. What is Z plus? Z plus is the set of all non-negative integers. Okay, this is what it is given. So in Z plus, star is defined by A star B is equal to A minus B. Okay, now clearly see, if we take anything, suppose A and B, that belongs to the set of positive integers, right? So we are taking anything, suppose A equal to 2, B equal to 3, such that A is less than B. So A star B gives me A minus B, right? So if I take A less than B, suppose this, so 2 minus 3, I'm going to get minus 1, which is not in Z plus. Okay, so this exceeds our limit that we have set about the domain or range. So we are going to write clearly, it is not a binary operation. It is not a binary operation. Why? As image of x, y under star, where x, y belongs to z plus and x less than y. We take an x such that it is less than y. Under star, we are taking the image of x, y will give us x star y is equal to x minus y, which is less than 0 because x is less than y and it does not belong to the set z plus. So it is clearly not a binary operation. So we completed the first part of this question. Now coming to the second part, similarly we have to show this, it's very easy. Now we are defining A star B such that it is equal to AB. It is also on Z plus. Now see, it is very simple. If A and B are positive integers, or you may say non-negative integers, then AB is also must have to be either positive or zero. If you take 0 into the account of Z plus, so it will not be negative. In primary words, it will never be negative. It will be a unique element under the domain. So we can clearly see it to be a binary operation. So on Z plus, star is defined such as A star B is equal to AB. Clearly, for all a comma b belongs to z plus, there exists an unique element AB in Z plus. It is very clear. Okay, so therefore each pair corresponds to a unique element. So therefore each pair A comma B corresponds to a unique element. A star B is equal to AB in Z plus, right? So therefore we can say star is a binary operation. See, star can be binary or non-binary as much if we just shift the domain to something else. The decision of whether star is binary or not by binary can be changed. You see, if this is instead of Z plus, it is simply Z, then it would get to be a binary operation. This much certainty is. Now coming to 3, it is given by on R the set of real numbers, we define star by A star B equal to AB square. So this is pretty clear. I hope it is pretty clear to all of you. So in a very similar manner, we will be writing on R star is defined by A star B is equal to AB square. Okay, now clearly for all AB that belongs to R, there exists an unique element AB square in R. It is very clear, never mind the crows, they are all wave only. So since for all A and B there exists an unique element AB square, and that also belongs to the real number, that is for sure. So we can say this implies that each pair A comma B corresponds to a unique element AB square in R. Alright, therefore star is a binary operation. I hope it is very clear. You have no doubt in it. Okay, so the next question says that on Z plus we define A star B such that it is equal to modulus of A minus B. Okay, now that's pretty easy if we consider it. So let's start. It is given on Z plus star is defined by A star B is equal to modulus of A minus B. Okay, now clearly you can see that for all A comma B belongs to this domain and range, not exactly domain and range, on the set where A and B elements are defined, there exists an unique element A minus B in Z plus. See, since A minus B can be anything, positive or negative, but modulus of A minus B is always non-negative, okay, and that belongs to Z plus. So obviously if you do any kind of operation such that A star B is equal to A minus B modulus of A minus B, so you will always get a non-negative integer. Okay, so we wrote this statement. Now this implies each pair A comma B corresponds to a unique element A star B is equal to modulus of A minus B, that is in Z plus. Okay, so therefore we can conclude that star is a binary operation. You are writing it just for getting marks in the sake of boards, but it is very clearly visible. You can just see it and tell whether it is a binary operation or not. It is so simple. We have to just do this drama for boards. There's nothing else. Okay. So, coming to the next question. So, it is said that on Z plus, we define an operation, binary operation, by A star B that is equal to A. Once again, it is pretty simple. Just have a look here. So, on Z plus, operation is defined by A star B is equal to A. Now see, it is very simple. Since A and B both belongs to the non-negative set of integers, then anything you input here will stay in the non-negative set, in this set only. So it don't go out of this set, and this is a successful operation. You can treat any two elements with this relation, this operation, right? So clearly we can write, clearly each pair, see here is nothing to explain much, it is very simple. Each pair A comma B corresponds to a unique element A star B is equal to A in Z plus. Therefore, star is a binary operation. Just as simple as drinking water, nothing else. You just have to identify whether it is binary or not. Okay, so let's skip it up to this in this video. In the next video, I'll be discussing the second question, from where we will be dealing with whether an operation is commutative and this sort of things. You have studied, you may have forgotten most of the things because it was not necessary that time, but here when you are considering operations, this come into fact, like the distributive property, commutative property, associative property. These properties, now you have to verify that whether these properties exist in an operation or not. That we'll be dealing in the next question. Today, let's keep it up to this. Hope you have enjoyed this video. Thank you very much for watching this video.